Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Let's Chat with Tita Gracie. Now, that last video was truly breathtaking. And I'm so proud that my friends Noel Rayos and Roy Rolyoda found the time to put that video together and share that video with us tonight. I am truly honored. And on behalf of V81 Radio, I thank you. And I'm sure that one day we are all going to be out there. But in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we have to keep on staying at home. And as you know, that this show is dedicated to giving you 2 hours of relief every week with great performances, artists from here and abroad, Filipinos who grace the world stages are going to be featured every week. So remain with us. And I'm sure that somewhere out there, you're going to be seeing them in a stage near you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, my next guest certainly is no stranger to the stage. He has been entertaining us from the time that he was still in school. And to this day, he still graces many fantastic shows. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome a very talented musical artist, ladies and gentlemen, Juan Miguel Salvador.
Hi, Tita Gracie. That was very, very kind of you. Thank you so much for that intro. And I'd like to greet everybody. Good evening, good morning, and good afternoon, whichever time zone you are in.
Yes, you know, I'll call you Badong because I know that.
Yeah, sure. Feel
free. You Badong, and I know that since the 80s, or not 70s, 80s, right?
80s,
right?
Yeah.
With the Kundirana, you started your musical career with Kundirana.
Oh, 1979, 1980. Oh, you're right. 70s pa.
Yes, but the Kundirana was such a tremendous choir, right?
It still is.
So, you know, when I planned tonight's episode, I was thinking of featuring chorals, no? Choral performances, virtual choral performances. Tonight, I think that we had a pretty good sampler of the choir scene.
And Tita Gracie, I can relate kasi back in the early 80s, I used to teach chorals also from different schools. And we used to compete in the Sambeda Choral Collection. And yes, a few of them won, actually. So,
and if you take a closer look at Kundirana, it was such a rich treasure trove of talent because...
Oh, that's right. That's
you've
right.
Got
the music
a lot
industry.
Of, yes, the Philippine music industry. Yeah. So rife with talent from the Kundirana.
Correct. We're talking about Gary V, Randy Santiago, Ding Dong Avanzado, Ogie Alcacid, and the likes.
Yes, and so you were with the Kundirana, and then from school, you moved on to the professional stage with
groundbreaking
Rage Band in the
80s. By accident, may I say, by accident. I was looking for a manager to manage a solo career, for some reason, I met a manager who Ate Casinto, who decided he wanted to form a band, so that's how it happened. All of a sudden, I was with a rock band.
Yes, and Ate Casinto, for some of us who can still remember, was instrumental in putting the circus band together.
Correct, that's right. A band from which singers like Hachi Alejandro, Basil Valdez,
Paz Dadiva,
Pili Moreno, Pat Castillo.
Of OPM, right. You know. And I know that... the Rage Band, when they tapped you, it was so timely because the 80s saw this tremendous burst in music from the UK, from Europe, from the US, you know, with the whole new world, new music and punk and all that. So what was it like to be part of that scene?
Oh, it was fantastic. It was like... it was so exciting, especially at that age, you know, and all of a sudden you're thrown into the live stage. Rage Band was only in the bar scene for a while, because all of a sudden we were catapulted to performing at big venues like Araneta Coliseum, Rizal Theater, the University of Life Theater. And yes. Immediately after that, we started traveling to Malaysia, to Singapore, so to Korea. So yeah. it was very exciting. Very exciting.
Especially yes, and right. And for you, it opened a lot of doors, I'm sure, because
yes, and the training was fantastic.
Yes, yes. You know, the music industry is, especially the Philippines, no, we end up having Filipino performers in bars, in theaters all over the world.
Exactly.
And you saw a couple of my friends who were performing in Hong Kong and Genting Highland. We occupied the stage.
Yes.
The Filipino performer is unequaled, unparalleled.
Unequaled.
Right?
I have to agree with that.
Yes, yes. And in my show, I want to honor that. I want to honor these performers, these artists, and really give them a platform to reach out to.
Thank you, Tita Gracie, for what you're doing for the musicians.
And you know, I was surfing the internet last week.
Yes.
And I surfed all the time. I'm online all the time. Mm. I came across this message from you. And I do that before the lockdown, you were very busy in the nightclub scene with the Authority band.
Correct.
And I had the pleasure of engaging your band in a big party in my previous company. And
that was fun. Yeah, that was fun.
We closed down Valkyrie and
I remember
my foreign boss. My foreign boss. Where did you find these people?
They were so
impressed. They didn't realize that, you know, there was a band that could do all these great 80s covers. I said, "Ba, gusto niyo nang you like 80s music? Well, I think you just have the right people to perform." And I remember I called you up for that.
Thank you, Gracie.
But let's take a closer look at this advocacy of yours, because after the lockdown happened, our friends in the industry have no more gigs.
Correct.
And, that's very sad. That saddens my heart. Maybe
that's
you'd
true.
Like to get an idea about this advocacy that you have. Share it with our friends listening.
Well, Tita Gracie, you know how it happened. Let me tell you the story. We had been in lockdown for a month already. And it was exactly April 16, early in the morning. Not too early in the morning, not for me. Because I sleep long hours. No, singers usually sleep long hours. But that particular morning, my wife Cheryl woke me up and said, "Wake up, wake up!" So I was wondering what she wanted to say, and she told me that so many people are moving and we were not. So I asked her to explain what she meant by it, and apparently, she had the intention of putting up a fundraiser in aid of initially live bands who lost their jobs and are stuck at home with no means of earning money.
And in God bless Cheryl, really, because I know that a lot of musicians are also grateful for the assistance, because we don't know. There's no end in sight. We do know that the lockdown will end hopefully by May 15,
but
it will take a while to revive the scene.
And unfortunately, we believe, my wife and I believe, that the live band scene and a lot of performers, we are going to be the last to be addressed. Because our kind of job entails mass gathering, so
yes,
it's going to be difficult for the government to suddenly think, okay, you can start performing.
Yes. Yeah. I know that the priority are the industries and the businesses that provide essential products and services.
Correct.
And
yes.
Correct. Our sector. I'm in the event sector. Yes. Us in the creative sector, the artist sector,
Same, I'm sure.
We don't know. We are trying. Yeah. We as much as we want to hurry things up, we know and we have our feet on the ground, and we have to be realistic that we must be patient. But in the meantime, talent, creativity, our energies cannot be contained.
Yes. In fact, you know, I enjoyed that number by Quasimodo, the cast.
Yeah.
That was, oh my God, I was getting teary-eyed with that.
You know, it's amazing because since the lockdown happened, virtual performances just blossomed.
I have to do that.
Virtual performances blossomed. Everyone from Lady Gaga to Andrea Bocelli to John and all these big name artists doing virtual performances. We even have Patrick Stewart reciting Shakespeare every day.
Yes.
Conducting a sing-along online. When in the history of performing arts do you have these big names of business not thinking about income or profit, but just being one with humanity?
Yes.
We are experiencing a universal phenomenon.
Yes, Tita Gracie, I don't know if you share the same idea with me. They call it the new norm, but they call it the new norm, but I call it the alternative means of performing using social media platforms. One way or another, things will get back to normal. So now they call this the new norm. But actually, what is happening now is another means of reaching out to people.
True. And, you know, this new normal that we have in the entertainment and the events business and the gig economy will be here for the long haul.
That is right.
I think as far as marketing our brand, your brand is the authority. My brand is the Gracie.
Yes.
To know how to use this platform as a marketing and communications tool to reach out to our audience. Because, you know, in the marketing world, out of sight, out of mind.
Correct.
And not allow this thing, this whole global pandemic, to defeat us. I mean, we've got to have hope. We've got to have that spark of hope. And the music industry is lending itself to this fantastic outpouring of hope to everyone.
Exactly. Even you, Tita Gracie, you're doing a great job.
You're doing a great job.
Fantastic.
Thank you. Thank you so much. But I cannot do this without partnering with my friends in the industry, with you, Adong. I'm so grateful. And I do know that we have a few more minutes left, but before that, announce how friends out there, our audience, can help you to help our musicians.
All right, let me share this. As of late, we have received donations to the amount of 370,000. That's only in a few days, like six to 7 days. And we have been able to extend aid to musicians, exactly 123 people so far. But we have a long way to go. So I'm appealing to the kind people out there, not just our fellow musicians, but from all industries. If you have time and you have the heart, please give to the musicians. We call it the Musicians in Need. It's a fundraiser for musicians in need, which started only as an aid for live bands. But as of far, we have been able to help people who work behind the scenes, like personal assistants, bar attendants, even cooks from some bars.
Yes.
Anything that has to do with the same industry.
Yes. you know, the entertainment industry, the gig economy is supported by a lot of people. We cannot be the great, we cannot give a great performance or put together a flawless, perfect event without our PAs, our writers, our lighting people, our stage hands.
And we get,
And
Tita, we get a lot of messages. If they log on to the site, which I will mention later, we get a lot of messages, tuloy-tuloy yan, and it doesn't stop. And it's reached hundreds already. So we have a lot of issues to address.
So once again, it's called Musicians in Need.
Correct.
And you have a website and a number?
Yes, we do have a website. It's Facebook. It's facebook.com/theauthorityband. Once again, facebook.com/theauthorityband. If you log on to that site, you will see exactly what we're doing because everything is transparent. Our mission is to give 3,000 in aid per musician, which we have been doing. So you'll see everything. Everything's transparent. All transactions are there. So
God bless you.
Please help.
And I'm appealing to all the like-hearted people out there.
Yes.
If I know that since this lockdown started,
he's
been generous with their resources. Baka naman may isa pang pwede tayong matulungan na grupo ang ating mga musikero, ang ating mga events people, people in the entertainment industry, the musical industry. I know that the group of Mr. C, sila Ryan Kayabyab, have been also doing Bayanihan Musikahan. Last week, we had 2 weeks, we had Moy Ortiz with us. And, you know, he also shared with us their experiences. But tonight, ladies and gentlemen, please log on to the Authority Band. That's, look for them in Facebook. That's
facebook.com/theauthorityband.
Yes. And the project is called Musicians in Need.
Yes. Madami. Thank you, Tita.
Kailangan ng tulong, tulungan po natin. Tulungan natin sila Juan Miguel Salvador para makatulungan ang ating mga kasamahan sa music industry ng Pilipinas.
Yes, Tita Gracie. Thank you.
Bago tayo, before we move and to close the show, no, this morning, I opened my email and I was floored with this beautiful song. And thank you for giving us the permission to share it with our audiences. If you were in tears because of the Quasimodo number, I was in tears. Same with my mom. We must have listened to this song about 10 times.
I love that song.
So can you give us an idea about this particular composition?
Well, it's a song that I wrote in 30 minutes because I was so inspired during that time. It was 2012, and I was inspired by the Lord to write an inspirational song, and I called it Para Sa'yo, Ama. I immediately recorded it and uploaded it to YouTube, and lo and behold, I got a call from Genesis that Gary was very interested in recording his own version. And that version that Gary sang was noticed by the Catholic Mass Media Awards group, and they awarded him for Best Inspirational Song in 2014, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, you know, it's a blessing. We did not plan this earlier.
I know.
We had no plan and I had no idea. I just wanted to invite you tonight to be of I wanted to help you raise funds for your advocacy.
Thank you.
Then you told me that I realized you were part of Kundirana, and that's a choir. And we were talking about virtual choirs, and I was talking to the people in the choir community.
There was a link.
Truly, the Lord's plan is at work.
Yes.
The plan of the Lord is at work to make this show possible tonight. And I'm so grateful to you. I'm so grateful to all our guests tonight for sharing their beautiful pieces, their virtual performances. And I hope that we shared a few minutes of time and relaxation and peace and blessings with our audiences, because I do know that one day we're going to be out there again, maybe the new normal. We'll be able to share our time, our talents with our audiences once again. And certainly for you, Badong, I wish you all the best. I love
you, Gracie.
And I am a big fan of yours. I love your sister, Vicky. You know, we're very good friends from a...
And your brother is my neighbor.
Yes, he's just right there. Yeah, you know, I consider you and Vicky part of my family, my entertainment family and my Assumption family. And since San Lo days pa, we were neighbors there. No, so
yes.
This song is such a fitting way to be the finale of the show tonight, because it is a prayer.
Yes.
Giving back the glory and honor to our Lord. Kasi sa kanya ng lahat ng talents na to.
Correct.
And you know, talent is, you know, we're a pious lot. We hold on to the Lord in times of jubilation and more so in times of tragedy like what's happening now. And there is no better way to end tonight's show than to share this piece of music. And Badong, maraming salamat.
Amen. Amen to that. Thank you, Tita Gracie.
Yes, I wish you well, my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, Juan Miguel Salvador has been around in the music scene for many years, still out there, still sharing so much of his talent and his expertise with us in so many ways. And being part of our scene, his heart is in the right place. Because this time, we want to help our musicians, our stage personnel, the people behind the scenes that entertain us, bring joy to us during times of normal, during the normal times. But these days, it's extraordinary times. We live in a time of pandemic, something we did not anticipate. Nobody saw this coming. We are responding as best as we could. And how do us in the entertainment and events industry respond? By sharing our talent. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, here is a special video of a song composed by Juan Miguel Salvador, Para Sa'yo, Ama.
Sa'yo Panginoon, tanggapin mo at gawin banal ito. Turuan mo kami maging mapagdasal, maging mapagbigay, maging iyong kamay. Para sa'yo, Ama, nilalaman ng isip ko. Para sa'yo, Ama, bawat tibok ng puso. Pagkat sa'yo nagsimula lahat ng yaman sa mundo. Muling inaalay para sa'yo. Maging mapagdasal, maging mapagdasal. ng isip ko. Para sa'yo, Ama, bawat tibok ng puso ko. Pagkat sa'yo nagsimula lahat ng yaman sa mundo, muling inaalay para.
Leading personalities, representative insights, relevant current issues all together in a meaningful and delightful conversations as your social barometer. Let's chat with Tita Gracie. Let's chat with Tita Gracie. Sundays, 6 p.m. Hosted by breakthrough millennial boomer Gracie Venezuela. Let's chat with Tita Gracie. Only here on V81 Radio. Tunog Pinoy, Tatap Pinoy,
the future of radio.
This is your all hits, all Pinoy internet radio station. This is V81 Radio Worldwide.
Ito ang paborito ng bawat Pilipino.
Basta all hits, all Pinoy.
Panalo, merong kwentong iyakan at tawanan.
Kahit nasaan ka man ito'y
mapapakinggan.
Right.